Right, now we are on step 5. Make the links 6-6F. Whether they are visited or not, take the underline off and instead put on a dotted border, the same one we used for H1. Yeah, I can see it there. So it looks like the links are going to be 6-6F in color. And a dotted border. And on step 6, that's about making a hover tag. So the hover tag is called a pseudo class. That's what you'll learn today, is a pseudo class. All right, the link selector is the A tag. And since I've already built this for the H1, I'll just copy it here. Save, and there it is. Oh, the color though is still that regular link color. Let me get the color in. That's the border. A color, and I want this same color, so I'll put that in like that. Save. There, the color is right. The dotted line is there. I need to get rid of that underline. So that is text decoration. And we're going to choose none. Save and look at that. Very nice. Now the pseudo class. Let's look up pseudo classes, just so you can see. Link pseudo classes. So a pseudo class is when you style an element that you can mouse over it, so that you can, and you can also style visited and unvisited links differently. So I'm going to just show you. Here's a lot of options. These are all pseudo classes. They have a semicolon after the A, and then you would talk about the link itself if it's unvisited, a visited if it is visited, a hover if it's going to be a mouse over, and an active, that's when you just hover your mouse over it. So here we're going to say a hover. And now I will copy this, actually both of these, and then I'm going to change this color to that dark red. Where is it? Right here. Copy. Because I want the hover to be red. Save. Now let's look at it. Oh, it's just the underline that's red. I need to add a hover color. Oh, I'll just type color. And the red is there in my saved colors. There we go. All right. It looks good. That's it for the beginning 3 videos of this lab. Next, we're going to learn some new things.